Today, I want you to learn in just over 5 minutes why the geometric mean is so important for financial data. To do so, suppose that you've invested your money with a so-called financial guru, Frank, and after leaving $10,000 with him for 2 years, Frank lets you know that he's earned you a 25% annual return on your money. Now, this is pretty exciting news, and so you log into your investment account later that evening, looking forward to seeing just how much money is in it now. However, you're fairly perplexed when it shows that you still have just $10,000. Frank, what's the deal? Well, Frank, of course, has a justification for his statement. Frank notes that 2 years ago was a great year. Your $10,000 became $20,000, gaining 100%. Last year was a down year, though. The market was down 50%, and so your $20,000 returned back to $10,000. And of course, the average of 100% and minus 50% is simply 25%. On the surface, Frank seems right. But is he really right? Something about his answer seems deceitful at best. The short answer is that Frank was missing an important adjective in his statement. He was reporting to you the arithmetic mean, the mean that we all learn about in school. But there are other types of means, and perhaps the most relevant in the world of finance and investments is the geometric mean. So let's discuss why that is the case. Let's do so by first writing out the formal equation that describes the arithmetic mean. With n observations, we simply sum up the value of each observation x and divide by n. Now let's ignore our equation and work out an intuitive example. If I gave you the set of values 1, 2, and 3, you would likely tell me very quickly the mean or average is 2, and you did so without explicitly realizing it or not, via the mathematical definition I've written out above. Now, a nice way I like to view the arithmetic mean is that if all observations had the same value, what value would yield the same observed total? In this case, 6. And for this problem, the answer would be 2. Now, the geometric mean is computed quite differently. With n observations, we multiply or take the product of each observation and raise it to the 1 over n. In the case of 1, 2, and 3, the geometric mean would be 6 raised to the 1/3. So, unlike the arithmetic mean, the geometric mean answers a different question. Specifically, if all observations took on the same value, what value would be needed to achieve the same product? In this case, 1 times 2 times 3 equals 6, and 6 to the 1/3 multiplied 3 times together also yields 6. So, why do we like the geometric mean? Because investments and financial series tend to grow in a multiplicative nature, and so the geometric mean gives us a better sense of our actual past performance. In the case of Frank's return, he has earned us $10,000 times 1 plus 1, followed by $20,000 times 1 minus 0.5. So let's compute the geometric mean of this sequence, keeping in mind that what is really being multiplied together is 1 plus the growth rate for the investment each year, which I'll denote as R. This product should be positive given that 1 plus r should be greater than 0, which is an important consideration when computing any geometric mean. And by working out the math, we can note that based on the geometric mean definition, Frank's average return has been 0%, which makes intuitive sense. We began with $10,000 and we still have $10,000 2 years later, and so there has been no change in our investment value. And what is pretty neat is that irrespective of how the in-between years played out, if you started with $10,000 and ended with $10,000, the geometric mean would inform you that, as you correctly would have thought, your average return has been in fact 0%. So what we now know is that, unlike the arithmetic mean, the geometric mean does a good job of reflecting the average performance for a dataset in which there is a multiplicative relationship between values. Having said that, there is also one more important thing that I want to note, which is that the arithmetic mean tends to be noticeably higher than the geometric mean, and so using the arithmetic mean may drastically overestimate your investment return. Let's go back to Frank. Over the past 2 years, Frank's performance in terms of the geometric mean has been 0, while he has earned you a 25% return in terms of the arithmetic mean. Let's now play out a range of situations in which we start with $10,000 and end with $10,000. And let's plot on the y-axis the difference between the arithmetic and geometric mean, and along the x-axis the difference between the growth rates for the 2 years. What we can clearly see is that the arithmetic mean is always greater than or equal to the geometric mean. And in fact, the only case where the two means are the same is when both growth rates R1 and R2 are the same. And there is a nice simple proof to show this. And so to highlight the practical significance of this, I decided to look at the annual return of the five largest companies in the US over the last 10 years and compare their arithmetic mean returns to their geometric means. Now, putting together this table made me really regret not investing in Nvidia years ago, but that is another story. What we can see here is that if you invested in any of these companies, you have done quite well for yourself, far better than Frank. But you can also see that the arithmetic mean is larger than the geometric mean by 3 to 26%, which is definitely not a trivial amount. So in summary, having watched this video, when you discuss investment returns with Frank or any other financial guru in the future, and they tell you that their average return is some obscenely high value, make sure that they disclose that that value is the geometric mean. And if they don't know the difference between the arithmetic and geometric means, perhaps you should oversee your fortune yourself. See you next time, and thanks again for your support.